Lights Up Bronx Arts. Today is Thursday, April 16th, 2020, and today is Jersey Day. And tomorrow for Spirit Week is Pajama Day. And stay tuned for, at the end, we're going to show some of the crazy hairs from Crazy Hair Day.
Absolutely. Good morning, Bronx Arts. It is Mr. Canuel here. I'm repping my Red Wings. Let's go, Red Wings. So I'm excited to see everyone in their jerseys today. Also, you know, if you don't have like a professional sports jersey, maybe ask your parents if they have an old high school or teen jersey. Maybe you are on a sports team that you can't be a part of right now because of everything that is going on and you want to rep that. Anything is acceptable, t-shirt, whatever. Let's break them out and let's flood our Google Meets with some jerseys today. All right. Justin, I know you're a big fan, obviously Kansas City, Super Bowl champs. What are you doing now that we can't see a whole lot of sports?
Well, since we can't see a lot of sports now, what I like doing is playing with my brother and my stepdad's sports in our yard. So even though we can't watch the sports we enjoy, we can still play with this distance learning.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And just like Mr. Rabin said and Mr. Bizon said, you know, there are YouTube channels that are showing classic games and Wednesday nights, I believe Mr. Bizon said that you can catch some basketball games. My first announcement and only announcement today is advisory meetings. Your advisors are reaching out to you via email and other forms of contact to meet them maybe once a week. These are very informal advisory meetings. They just want to check in with you and make sure that you're staying safe and healthy, seeing how they can help you be successful in your Google Classrooms, give you some tips, tricks, and you know, maybe listen to some music, share some stories, that sort of thing. So be on the lookout for those and be sure that you are being a part of those meetings as well. One of my favorite segments that we've been doing, good news segment. Good news segment. Justin, give me some good news, man.
Some good news that I have is over the weekend on Sunday, I was able to build one of my Lego sets that I had. And it was good news for me because I earned my way towards being able to build it and me getting my grades higher and my parents noticing my hard work. So it was very special for me, for them to know that I've been working hard so I can play with the Lego and get my grades up.
Amazing. So this was like a little bit of an incentive, like you got good grades, so you're able to do that. You know, that's awesome. And, you know, that is certainly building something like that takes a lot of time and effort, perseverance, that sort of thing. So it's good practice for all the things that you do. My good news, I just heard that in 2019, almost 75% of the added resources were renewable resources to the planet and the country. So good things are happening for the planet, which is really exciting. So wind and solar was really instrumental in 2019, which is awesome. So hopefully our governments and people in charge of these sorts of things that donate to these types of things continue that going. So that's good news. Oh, what? Is that some birthday music I hear? Oh, yeah. Must be somebody's birthday today. Justin, whose birthday is it?
Well, today's birthday, I want to say happy birthday to Isis Bradley. And I want to say happy birthday to Savannah Viara. So
awesome.
Happy birthday, guys.
Happy birthday. Yeah, that's Isis and Savannah. Happy birthday, you guys. If you have a birthday coming up, we will try and feature you as much as possible. Have a wonderful day. All right, DJ, you can turn the music off now. All right. So, Justin told me that I recently forgot to give some answers to riddles, and we are going to go into a new riddle today. So, back to some old riddles, and one of these was bothering Justin. So one of them was, it belongs to you, but everyone else uses it. Did you know the answer to that one, Justin?
Yes, I knew the answer to that one. The answer to that one was, I think, your name.
It is your name. It belongs to you, but everyone else uses it, right? Okay, the second one on that time was, say, three consecutive days without saying Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Justin, what was that one?
I don't know. That one got me.
All right. So the answer to that one is yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
Oh, I can't believe I didn't know that.
Yeah, you got to think outside the box for something like that.
I was thinking so hard. I was thinking it was like Christmas or something.
Oh, and maybe some holidays. That might have been interesting, but yesterday, today, and tomorrow is 3 consecutive days, right? Because Christmas and Halloween don't necessarily go right next to each other, so they're not consecutive. But that was good thinking. Today's riddle, and remember, you can email me at rcanuel@bronxarts.net if you think you know the answer. And this one was submitted by one of your fellow scholars, Carla. Carla sent me over this one. It's a tough one. I haven't been able to figure it out. It's still racking my brain. Here we go. What can run but never walk? What has a mouth but never speaks? What has a head but never weeps? What has a bed but never sleeps? All right. I'll say that one more time. What can run but never walk? Has a mouth but never talk? Has a head but never weeps? Has a bed but never sleeps. Justin, any ideas right now?
I think I have an idea of what it is, but I don't want to say it because I want the fellow scholars to answer it.
Oh, well, that's very kind of you. I got you. All right. Well, I look forward to your email when you think you have it figured out. Now, I want to go into a quick Google tip. And I think this is a quick awesome Google tip for both teachers and students. As we are beginning to get more comfortable with working with Google Classroom, I think I've been trying to work in a really efficient way to create documents and share documents and have the students submit documents without having to like share it. And then, it just puts everything in one place. So this Google tip is about creating a copy for every student and having students create assignments in create documents in the assignment. Here we are on the teacher-facing side of Google Classroom. I think this is really important and efficient way for teachers that haven't been able to make use of this style of creating assignments and documents or might want to use them in the future. So here I am. I've created a basic assignment. I've given it a title, and here we are. Here are some basic instructions that I have put in here. Now, what I'm going to do is I want to create a doc. This is great for like watching a video or reviewing some pictures or even short answers to a reading or something that has happened. So I go ahead and create that doc, and it's going to automatically open it up for me. And I go ahead and start creating, give it its title. And then, of course, I can format it in any way that I like. Then it's all saved in there. And then when I go back, the important thing is to really help organize and make sure that students can easily access and really eliminate any error of them not turning in something or messing up when they turn something in is to make a copy for each student. Okay. And this will automatically change as soon as you assign it to the name of the document. Right. You can, there's slide sheets, there's other things I'm sure that you have all been using. But here we go. I'm going to go ahead and assign it, and then I'll show the scholars how they can make use of this and some things to stay away from. And boom, it's right there. So scholars, here we are. So what you notice is that right here is the document that the teacher has created for you. Okay. The other way that you can view it, obviously, is going to your classwork, clicking test assignment and view assignment, just like Miss Cotton showed us a couple of weeks ago. But what's really great about this is that you don't have to create your own document that's sort of already created there for you. It has your name right there and the name of the assignment already taken care of. So you go ahead and answer your assignment. You should watch it every day, and then you can click turn in. Okay. Now, here's some things that you can also do. Say a teacher might ask you to create a document and upload your own videos or copy and paste some links into that document, or maybe they want you to find some pictures and copy some paste some pictures into a document. Don't create a new document here. don't do this, and I'll show you why. Because when you do this, right, you're going to create a blank document. All of a sudden, it doesn't do the work for you. Make it easy, and this will be way more efficient, right? So over here, there's no title already given for you, and the work is not there. And here, there's no turn-in button, okay? See the difference? Turn-in button already done for you. All the work is there. If you really need to create something from scratch, do it within the assignment. Don't do the tic-tac-toe create a doc. Create a new assignment here, okay? Here we go. So we create a new one here, and it's basically the same thing. It's going to create a document, test assignment, and this will create a blank document. That's a way that you create a blank document. Still has your name and the name of the assignment, so the teacher knows which assignment that you're referring to. And again, another turn-in button over here for you, okay? That's how you know. But when you go back in here, you've completed everything. We want to make sure that that is completed, right? We answered on, okay, every day, good. I did click the turn-in button over there previously. I want to make sure that I turn it in right over here. So then I'm going to turn it in just like that, right? Sometimes you don't need to create your own because the teacher has already done it for you, right? That's only if the instructions say create your own document. You want to do it within your assignment right here so that it has the name and all the information. Don't go up here and create a new doc. I know a lot of you know how to do that, and that's great, but let's do it here when we're working within Google Classroom. So we're going to go back to the teacher side, and we should be able to see, oh, one turned in. Amazing. And look at that. The attachments are all right here. And when I click on them, I know that Justin is doing it because it's going to bring it up for me. Nice. Look, there it is. Just like we did it in there. And then I can give him his grade and return it. And everything is nice and neat. So hopefully that is helpful. And that is how we create documents and share them with each other so that we don't have to create extra folders or share those sorts of things. So hopefully that was helpful. And please let me know if you have any Google tips that we should include in Lights Up. And now we are going to go into the letter of the day. Justin, tell us, what is the letter of the day?
Today's letter of the day is S, which what stands for me, is Super Bowl winners.
You just had to get that in there, didn't you?
I had to.
Okay, I was rooting for Kansas City too. I was rooting for, it was a good game. It was a good game. All right. Well, everyone, have a great Jersey day. Thank you so much for watching Lights Up. Enjoy. Work hard. Turn in your assignments. Have a great day, Bronx Arts. Bye.
Bye.